What's up, everybody? Go Burns, doing my review of the latest update from Grand Theft Auto Online, Gun and Stunts Special Vehicle Circuit. By the way, if you have an opinion regarding this update, feel free and let me know below in the comment section. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Do you not really feel one way or the other about the Special Vehicle Circuit? Feel free and chime in below in the comment section. So as usual with my review series, we go over the pros, we go over the cons, then my verdict as to what I think about the update overall. So let's get to it, shall we? The pros. And spoilers, there really isn't many pros to this update because there really wasn't much to the update. Now, obviously the big seller to the Special Vehicle Circuit update is the 20 new stunt races for three of the special vehicles, which include the Ruiner 2000, aka Kit, the Rocket Voltic, and of course the Blaze Aqua. Now, as someone who loves racing in Grand Theft Auto Online and also does a series called Racing Badly, I did an episode yesterday. I'm going to do another one tomorrow, which is my usual time for Racing Badly on Saturdays. I'm happy about that because I love new races to check out. And it's very interesting to see these special vehicles being used in races. So for anyone into races and loves the cunning stunt races and really wanted to see how the Ruiner 2000, the Rocket Voltic, and even the Blazer Aqua would do in races, yeah, this is definitely going to be a pro for everyone out there that loves races. Now, the other pro was the ProGen GP1, which is the newest supercar in the game. The one thing I like about this car is she has plenty of mods, a ton of mods, and she's sexy looking. But I feel like that this car doesn't belong in the super class because as other YouTubers like Bruffy has pointed out in his videos, she just can't really perform against the top 10 supercars. And I think she would have been better suited over in the Sports Classic, especially since the ProGen GP1 is based off of, you know, car from like the 80s, 90s era. I think McLaren or maybe Celine, one of those. But anyway, she feels like an older car and I think she would have been better suited in the Sports Classic category as opposed to the Super category. But still, she's a very, very nice car to have. The other pro is, of course, the bugs and fixes. As always with these updates, they fix a number of issues and they hopefully improve the game. So that's why overall I give the bugs and fixes a pro, even though there may be some that some of us may not really be too happy about. But the other pro is kind of like it's kind of like a prophecy pro, foretelling what is to come in the update. Now, we know a great deal about what's coming because Rockstar has informed us, plus, you know, files have been found. Obviously, two adversary modes, Resurrection as well as Top Down. Those are coming soon in the next few weeks, as well as the Cunning Stunt Special Vehicle Creator. That's something a lot of people are very excited about because some of the best races in Grand Theft Auto Online are user-created races, and I'm very, very excited about what the community is going to create for races for the special vehicle circuit for the Ruiner 2000, Rocket Voltic, and of course the Blazer Aqua. I'm the most excited about that one because unlike the other two cars, which do land in air technically, the Blazer Aqua does land in water. So it's going to be very fascinating to see what the creator community is going to come up with for races for these three special vehicles. Now, the other pro that we're going to add before we move on to the cons is the vehicles that are to come in the game. And it's also a con, but we'll talk about that in a minute. Now, at the end of the article that Rockstar posted Tuesday, they mentioned the cars that were coming. And we even see them at the end of the trailer. And other content creators out there have already featured them in a single player on the PC. Unfortunately, I don't have Grand Theft Auto 5 on PC, so I can't do that, and my PC couldn't even run it anyways. But we do have three other vehicles that are going to be dripped out, along with the adversary modes and the content creator for special vehicle races, including a sports car called the Rustin. I think it's based on a Mexican car, the Infernus Classic, as well as the Turismo Classic. Now, what I hear is that the Infernus and the Turismo Classics are going to be in the Sports Classic category, which, in my opinion, makes complete sense. For one thing, it says Classic at the end of their names. And B, I think the Sports Classic category needs more vehicles. And hopefully the Infernus Classic and the Turismo Classic will be up there in the top echelon to compete against all the other Sports Classics, including the Sterling GT. And I seriously think the ProGen GP1 should have been also added to the Sports Classic category as well. But That's Rockstar for you. And the final pro is the mention of a quote-unquote morbid muscle car, which most likely means that eventually, in the next few weeks, in addition to the three additional cars, the two adversary modes, the creator for special vehicle circuit, we're also going to finally get the Duke of Death in Grand Theft Auto Online. Hopefully. Now we're moving over to the cons, and there's a few cons. First off, no new clothing, no new masks, which I didn't really expect, but it would have been nice if we had some new masks. No new racing helmets. We could have used some racing helmets. And of course, no new weapons. Once again, I didn't really expect new weapons with this kind of update, but still, no new tattoos, no new hairstyles, no additional content besides one car on day one of this update, which is very, very disappointing. Even though the car is cool, it just doesn't really make sense to me that that's the only thing they'd have for sale on day one is just one vehicle. No additional clothing, even if it's race themed, even if it's the same like racing outfits and same racing helmets they've been using, but just different color schemes, different like sponsors, different liveries, different wraps on them. You know, it doesn't seem too difficult to do, but you know, last we did not get any new additional content with just one vehicle. Then of course, you know, like I mentioned, there's only one car that we got at the beginning, but we also have three more coming, and four if you technically count the morbid muscle car, aka the Duke of Death. And it really feels like that this is an update that did not need to have its content dripped out, because there's not an abundance of content on day one. There's only one vehicle, and that was it. So it really doesn't make sense for Rockstar to drip these cars out since there's only one vehicle. And I realize why they did it. It's the same formula that they've been doing for a while now, is to, you know, put out some content, then they try and, like, you know, keep the interest in the game, you know, going for the next few weeks or month after the update was put out by putting out, you know, an unlocked vehicle every week or so. But at the same time, it just feels like that in this case, it feels desperate. We'll talk about that at the end in the verdict. Of course, next is the heist vehicle instant access. This is a con. Now, in the video I did Tuesday regarding everything that came with the Cunning Stunt Special Vehicle Circuit update, after I did, of course, the GP1 video, I did not know exactly what the heist vehicle instant access was going to be. I had an idea, so I speculated. I was obviously wrong. What else is new? I'm only human, as far as I know. Now, the reason why I don't like the heist vehicle instant access is because I think that it's not necessary, because heists have been in Grand Theft Auto Online for 2 years now, and either people have done the heists and unlocked these vehicles, or they haven't. And I don't know if they're going to have any encouragement to do so, but I guess in a way I kind of see why Rockstar did this from that point of view, so that they don't have to unlock the Karumas, the armored Karuma, or any of the other vehicles. But I do not like the fact that not only did they see the need to, you know, make them available automatically, they decided they're going to put a few more bucks in their pocket, which is basically true. So it's very similar to how they have the special vehicles. So if you don't want to do the missions, you know, the cars, in order to get to the special vehicles, in order to get the discount, in order to purchase the Ruiner 2000 or the Blazer Aqua, the Rocket Voltic, etc., etc., you would pay a premium price, which I do think sucks, but they justify it for whatever rhyme or reason. And unfortunately, there's those of us that'll pay for it, especially when you're making videos and you don't have time to go and do all that. So anyways, they did raise the prices for anyone that wants to just go ahead and buy those heist vehicles now, instead of going through the heist, like the Karuma, originally at $95,000, is at $126,000. And of course, the armored version of the Karuma, which is the more popular of the two, if you actually get it in the Fleeca job, it's only $525,000. But they bumped the price for instant access up to nearly $700,000. Then, of course, the one boat that you unlock in the heist update, the dinghy, you know, it went up from $125,000 to $166,000 if you don't want to do the heist that unlocks it. Then, of course, most of the vehicles are in war stock. The more popular ones, like the Insurgents, the Insurgent with the gun on top, the pickup, you would unlock it and it would be only $1.3 million. But if you just want to buy it instant access, it's nearly $1.8 million. And of course, the regular Insurgent at originally $675,000 is up to nearly $900,000. The Hydra, this is like the biggest jump. So if you unlock the Hydra, it's $3 million. But if you just want to buy it without unlocking it, it costs almost $1 million more. And then the Valkyrie, it goes up to basically $900,000 more. And the Technical goes up at least, $2-3 million more, you know, between the, unlocking it or doing the instant access. The Mule, yes, even the Mule got a little price bump from $32,000 to $43,000. Of course, I don't honestly know who would want to buy the Mule to begin with, or the Boxville, which has gone up from $45,000 to nearly $60,000. The Savage, I love the Savage. I love that big, beautiful Russian broad. Now, if you unlock it, it's nearly $2 million. But if you decide to do the instant access for the Savage, it's $2.6 million. And the Mesa, you know, it doesn't raise in prices. It's still at $87,000, but there's a way you can get it for free. But finally, the Prison Bus, originally, if you unlock it, it's $550,000. And then, of course, the instant access price is $731,000. And I think I left off a plane, but that's besides the point. You see the issue I have. It's the fact that if you want these vehicles now, instead of doing the heist to earn them, you have to pay out front. You pay kind of a penalty for the Savage or the Valkyrie or the Technical or the Insurgents or the Hydra, for example, or the Armored Karuma. And yes, it makes it more convenient, I guess, for the gamers playing Grand Theft Auto Online that don't want to do the heist. But at the same time, I like the ability to earn something in the game. And I really don't see the instant access as anything other than a way to make more money at the gamer's expense. And the other con I have is deranking vehicles. Now, this goes along the line of the heist instant access. These are some of the Pegasus vehicles that have been in the game since the beginning, like the Rhino Tank, the Buzzard, the Annihilator, and even the Dubsta 6x6. All these vehicles unlocked whenever you reached a certain rank. It was something to look forward to, along with the various weapons. And I really am disappointed that they're deranked. Now, yes, it makes it easier for someone just joining the game to shell out a shark card to buy their own Rhino or their own Buzzard. But at the same time, I just feel like it takes something away from the game when you no longer have these vehicles that have been ranked since the beginning of Grand Theft Auto Online in October 2013. Now, it doesn't matter. You can get them right away. I mean, what are they going to do next? Derank all the weapons? I mean, there's just something I don't like about that. It feels wrong, in my opinion. It feels like just a way to get new gamers, new fans of the series that have just jumped on board in 2016, 2017, just to, you know, shell out more money to buy these various vehicles instead of first, you know, ranking up, earning money, grinding missions, heists, doing VIP work or biker jobs, in order to raise the money to first rank up through RP and then have the money by the time they rank up to where they can on their own purchase the Buzzard or the Rhino Tank or any of these vehicles that they want. Instead, it just seems like a quick and easy approach by Rockstar, and that's something I really don't like. And so it's definitely a con in my opinion, along with the heist vehicle instant access. Now, I don't expect everyone to agree with me on those points, but that's just my opinion and that's the point of my review. And the final con is the aggregate race position update that they put in races now. And I was not a fan of Destroy Last Place, but I do like this a little bit more than Destroy Last Place because usually I'm in last place and I don't even get to even a chance of finishing the race. I get blown up. That sucks. But with the aggregate race, the thing I don't like about it is the fact that I would like the opportunity to finish the race. Even if I don't get first place, or that's probably rarely going to happen. It does happen occasionally in my Race and Battle series, but very, very rarely. But I would like the opportunity, the chance to at least place instead of get a DNF. But I guess in a weird twisted way, that means that anytime I'm in a race, I don't have to worry about DNF anymore. But I don't know. I just like the ability, the chance, the opportunity to possibly finish the race without getting a DNF. So I don't know. I mean, it's kind of a con to me, but at the same time, I can see how I might like it because of the fact it means no more DNFs for me. But anyways, those are my pros. Those are my cons. And here's my verdict concerning Cunning Stunts, the special vehicle update. Other than the 20 new Rockstar created races, there's really not much else that this update offers besides the Progen GP1 and of course the additional content that's still currently locked, waiting to be dripped out to us in the next few weeks. If the Special Vehicle Circuit update had more to offer at launch, it would have been okay to wait on these additional items, like the three new cars, the adversary modes, and even the creator. But since Special Vehicle Circuit overall doesn't have much to offer compared to other updates on day one, it seems, like I said, a desperate measure by Rockstar to try and, you know, spread out this content like too little butter over too much bread. I'm using a Bilbo Baggins quote from Lord of the Rings. But it's true, though. I mean, I really wish that they would have just put all this into one update, because in the end, you would have only had technically, what, four cars? The GP1, Rustin, Infernus Classic, Turismo Classic. I mean, that's only four cars. I mean, in previous updates, we've had like way more cars come out on day one, and maybe even one of the adversary modes and the creator as well, or at least hold off on the creator and adversary modes, as well as the morbid muscle car, aka the Duke of Death. But alas, all we got on day one was the 20 stunt races and, of course, the Progen GP1. Now, in my opinion, it just feels like to me, as far as sequel updates go, because there's been several sequel DLCs, like Cunning Stunt Special Vehicle Circuit is a really bad sequel. And it's even worse than Custom Classics was to Lowriders. At least in Lowriders on day one, we got new clothing, we got, I think, a new weapon, I think we got several vehicles, but we also had vehicles that dripped out as well over the next few weeks. But still, there was a lot more to offer on day one to Custom Classics than day one for Cunning Stunts. And Cunning Stunts, unfortunately, is tailored specifically just for those interested in racing, unless, you know, the Progen GP1 happens to appeal to you. But once again, it's just one car and no clothing, no helmets, no additional content, except for one car until the others unlock over the next few weeks. But in all fairness, after, what, over 25 updates since, what, November 2013 with Beach Bum, you know, I mean, that's a lot of updates. It's a lot of content that Rockstar has put out over the past three going on 4 years in this game. And I can kind of understand the issue. I mean, they've put out a lot of stuff, different ideas, different, like, vehicles, different clothing, different features to the game, and I'm sure it's becoming more and more difficult to come up with new ideas, and it happens to the best of us. And it's very possible that a lot of the Rockstar development team is focusing more on Red Dead Redemption 2 right now in the fall. And I realize that there's two major development houses in Rockstar. You have Rockstar North, which is basically Grand Theft Auto, and then Rockstar San Diego, which is Red Dead, but they do work together, and chances are they probably have a lot of the assets at Rockstar North focusing on Red Dead Redemption 2, or possibly even the next Grand Theft Auto game, which means there's probably less people working on content for Grand Theft Auto Online. In other words, it's no surprise that Rockstar is most likely, you know, running out of ideas when it comes to updates. And the truth is, we're probably in the twilight year of Grand Theft Auto Online when it comes to new DLCs. I'd be very much surprised if we end up getting any new content in 2018. If we do, I'm going to be very thrilled and tickled pink about it. But I think I'm feeling it that this may very well be the last year that we get free DLCs in Grand Theft Auto Online. There may be some basic fixes and updates to the game in 2018, as long as people continue to play it on current gen, but I'm just not really feeling that Rockstar is going to be putting much effort into any more content, especially once Red Dead Redemption 2 comes out. But we at least still have one more update to look forward to this summer, and maybe a couple others as well in 2017. Gunrunning, so that is the one coming this summer, which I think is going to be probably an even more fun, exciting update that Rockstar has in the works for Grand Theft Auto Online. So there you have it. That's my review of Cunning Stunts, the Special Vehicle Circuit. Let me know once again your thoughts, your opinion, your views regarding the latest update to Grand Theft Auto Online.